name is Shima Joseph Ajav from Mass Communication Department, Benue State University. I'm a physically challenged student. Coming to Benue State University from the very beginning, I knew that I was going to face a lot of challenges. But as I came, I actually saw some of the things I didn't bargain for. I almost left. But I came in contact with him, gave me a little discouragement. Like that in my year one, especially when I came, I actually didn't come with my wheelchair. Okay. So you could imagine somebody that cannot walk coming to school on the bike. So I had like, because the hostel accommodation have not been given, have not been actually issued out to me. So I had to be coming from the town to access school. And then you had GSTs in the morning by 7. So I would take bike actually from town and to the school. And by the time I come to the school, the whole classroom is filled up. And the bike man will have to like carry me virtually, just carry me virtually from the bike to the ground. He put me on the ground and I will sit there. Sometimes I will not be able to even hear what the lecturer is saying, but I will still sit there, and after the lecture, they will still move to another hall and I will still be here. After an hour, sometimes the bike man will go and come back and pick me from that spot again to another venue. So it was actually challenging. I emaciated. When I even got to the hostel, after the hostel, and I was in the hostel, I knew nobody. So now, trying to even take my bath in that morning, trying to get into my wheelchair, trying to leave the hostel to the classroom, it's a bit of a distance from the hostel to the classroom, especially when you have 7 o'clock lectures and you have about 700 people scrambling for seats in the hall. So it was challenging. I would leave the hostel very late, very early, trying to leave the hostel on the wheelchair. Don't even the passion or the feeling to call somebody to help lift you from one spot to another was highly discouraging. Some people will even look at you like, seriously, can you be able to like succeed? But I kept at it, and at the point I almost went. By the time I was like half into the semester, I was almost giving up because I was stressed. Sometimes coming back, I have to just take ordinary curry to sleep. The weakness, I won't be able to do anything, not even cook. When I try to get water from the tap to wash, to cook, I faced a lot of difficulties in this regard. Like on a daily basis, you face so many challenges. Sometimes trying to move on the road, I face bombs, climbing staircases, trying to move from one particular end. It's been challenging. Nevertheless, I still feel a lot can be done in this regard if the people in charge can also consider our plight. Because trying to assess all these things with people that are probably, let's say, a bit stronger or a little bit mobile than you, it's also difficult. Like even the halls where you attend lectures, you see people scrambling from one place to another, trying to get seats from standing, and you're on the way. And in the case of whereby there's a stampede now, for instance, it becomes difficult. Or sometimes even when we're trying to lift from one staircase to another, you see somebody can just by mistake slip and you fall. There's no lift, there is no proper arrangement for people with disabilities to really attend this form of education. What has really kept me going is the desire to make it. The purpose. If you have a purpose in life, you have a focus in life, you are determined. Despite all these particular challenges, you still be motivated to attend, because I want to create my own. I want to let the world know me as a person. I want to also contribute to the society any little way I can, because I feel it's not by the physicality, it's by the content. Just like what Martin Luther King said, that he has a dream that one day his 4 kids will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. That is exactly what I want people to see. I don't be judged by my physicalities. I want people to judge me by the content of what I have, by what I can produce and what I can contribute to society.
Thank you. Shima. I call him Joe Hart. As somebody who is disabled and staying in a place where it's very hot and tight and trying to cope with it is not that easy. And I also understand about the person of Shima, that he's a kind of a hardworking person, like always trying to have people around, give tutorials, and like make things happen around him, bring friends together. He's somebody that believes in this saying that there's ability in disability. As such, he's somebody that never looked down on his person as a disabled person. Rather, he feels the same way people who are able feel. And he also believes that whatsoever somebody who is able can do, he can also do that. So he encourages people, both his fellow disabled persons, to like stand up to what is good for them and what is worth doing. They feel they can do it.
Despite the fact that he's physically challenged, he is still very intelligent. That doesn't distract him from his studies. And I as a person, personally, what I feel whenever I see him is I am challenged whenever I see him, because despite the fact that he's challenged, that doesn't stop him from going to school. Right now, we are in our final year, and I can bet you that he's one of the best students in my department at my level right now. So what I can say about him is that he's very intelligent, he's very caring, very friendly, and everyone around him, I can bet you that everyone in my class loves him, both students and lecturers.
I have this passion for education, but due to the environment, it is actually difficult and challenging. You can, from year one to year four, I've used three different wheelchairs. Right now I'm in year four and I'm still using another wheelchair. The tires are bad, it is challenging getting a new wheelchair. It's actually very difficult. I'm not asking for sympathy, I'm not asking for anything, but what I'm asking of is if for the government, if they can actually assist people like me in this situation, those, especially those that want to acquire education, those that want to contribute to the society. I pray that individuals, philanthropies come to assist, come and look at how they can help people, and those that even stakeholders in education can find ways incorporating people like us into education when they are planning some of this infrastructure, like this new platform project you see on campuses. They can do many, they can go a long way in assisting when it comes to aiding us, tie the road, giving us walkways whereby these wheelchairs can last for a very long time. I'm appealing to the government and spirited individuals out there to come to the aid of disabled people like me.
I'm a jobless man. But many people advised me to go and learn work because the work that I used to do before, I used to walk around asking what how my stomach was going to eat. But when I asked somebody to dash me money, he said that if the matter in my condition is I still have hands to do work. Then someday, sometimes I sit down and think about this advice is too much. I must make use of it. Then when I go to church, I cry to my God and say, Father, I want to do something with this advice. And I want my hands to have what to be doing so that I will be proud of myself. Then Almighty God answered my prayer. Say someone to me to teach me well how to get into the business. I do not know that I'm going to be a shoemaker. My idea is that let me go and learn radio mechanic. But see that opportunity come to do a shoemaker, I say okay, all work is work and money is money. Let me just follow this way. Then I go to the man shop. Direct me where he's working, then I go to his shop. Then he said, give me the day that I will start work. I start learning, trying to do my best, struggling well. Then the man said that I'm fucked up someone. I would like to be as a God, make her learn the work. So, no problem. So that one make her learn to the work, let me put my mind on this good job.
I'm learning shoemaking under David Ugbogi. And he's kind, I'm not paying anything in learning. He they give me transport. At times, even send money, they give change in my hand. And they buy me food every time, 2 times a day, before the clothes go out.
Have legs and have hands. If you don't have hand, you have leg. There is no pressure in banking.